everyone, welcome back to Enter the Gungeon with me, Flick, and we're going to enter straight away. We are ready. Playing as a Marine, my favourite character currently. How did the last run go? It went okay. We lost to the third floor boss. Cannon Balrog. We kind of got screwed over with our gun choices and also just a gun ammo situation. I feel like drop-wise I got really unlucky after the first floor. The first floor drops were really, really good. But after that, kind of went downhill. Also, the gun used by Manny's killer is not that great. What else did I have? I had the Super Soaker gun. That was kind of meh. Voidcore Assault Rifle was great, but I burned through the ammo too quick. And we got the grenade launcher, like just a normal grenade launcher for the first time. And although it sounded good against bosses, it just was doing nothing. So now I know next time if I get the grenade launcher again. It's a standard room clearer. That's important to remember as well. Amulet, I guess. Gold amulet, blank damage up. I didn't know blanks did damage. Oh yeah, it's okay, we bought that at the end of the last episode. Blanks will deal increased damage to enemies. Alright, I guess they do a default small amount and now it does more. This enchanted amulet is not actually made of gold, but brass from melted bullet casings. Even now it yearns to shoot at something. Okay. Yeah, once I become more familiar with the guns in the game, that looks like an evil face. It's going to become more obvious which guns you could classify as boss killers and which ones you could classify as room killers. I mean, I'm sure there's plenty of guns that can do both, but they'll be top tier. So when it comes to like standard fare, you're just going to see where a gun best fits. And I think also the Super Soaker is probably a room clearer rather than a boss clearer. Although I did use it on a boss, but it was that or the Rogue Special, and the Rogue Special sucks. Especially compared to this pistol. This pistol is effective and will get the job done. Alright, we found our shop nice and early. Might as well have a look in for the teleporter for one, and also just to see what's on offer. So we see the same thing? Yeah. So, I had this during my live stream I did recently. That I'm hoping you saw the VOD of, the little bomber. It's a Zelda reference. It's reasonably okay as a gun. 35, yeah, we could afford that by the end of floor, even though we're not playing as the pilot. We'll see. It also depends what's in the next chest that we get, although right now I obviously need to either find a key or... he didn't sell a key, did he? So I'd have to trust in just destroying it. Let's hope we get a very, very rare key drop at the end of a room. I suppose I'm being a bit down on the last run, but we also did free that King NPC and his weird helper, who may now turn up in the Gungeon. So there's that. Actually, you know what room I found during that livestream I did of Gungeon that I haven't found since getting back to recording episodes? Yet, like, every run I found it when I was livestreaming. It's a mirror room. That was close. I guess he instantly attacked me when I walked past him. Yeah, it's a mirror room where you can kind of see the reflection of a chest in the mirror. And you can open the chest as if it was there and you will get an item. But if you do that, it breaks the mirror, and you can also just break the mirror by hitting it. And it gives you Curse Up. I don't know if there's any advantages to getting Curse Up. All I know for sure is that it gives you a chance of running into like a cursed enemy, which is like super powerful. You can tell because they're like bright red and I took damage from that. And that! Good God. That was some of the worst damage I've ever taken. I am not used to taking damage on the first floor anymore. I guess I was too busy thinking about what I was saying. Yeah, I don't know what other advantages Curse has, but cursed enemies spawn. They're bright red, and they fire kind of like red and dark red bullets. So that's how you know that they're powered up by, like, Curse. It's so it seems, anyway. I'm not saying these things as fact, just kind of what it felt like from what I saw. Hey, we got a key, very nice. So, there's a room back here we missed. Here's hoping our other item room actually has a gun in it. If not, Little Bomber could get the job done, so I would buy it. I would also be willing to use the Marine Special, or whatever this is called, the Marine Pistol, I guess. I was thinking of Rogue Special from last time. I'd be willing to use this on a boss, but it increases the chance of getting hit by the boss, because it'll be a long fight. Can I use this? No. It looked like there was something on the table that I could use. Oh, it's the pillow gun! I had this last when I was streaming. So it's a pillow that shoots silenced pillows. Its damage is reasonable. Not amazing, just reasonable. We will save it for the boss. And we'll make use of it there. It fills the floor with feathers as well, and to reload it, you fluff it, and it's hilarious. It's a fun gun, and I think I remember saying during the live stream that if I'd got it on an earlier floor, it would have been much more effective. So the fact that we're getting it on the first floor is very positive. I don't recall which character I was playing as on the run where I got it, because the pillows will also be more accurate if we're playing as the Marine. That might come into play. We found both our chests, we found our shop, so now we just need the boss, which has to be down there. Who am I hoping for in terms of first floor bosses? I mean, who are the first floor bosses? Gatling Gull, the Twins, and Bullet King, right? Gatling Gull is probably the easiest, then Bullet King, then the Twins. Alright, I've got my pillow at the ready. It's Bullet King, time to put my money where my mouth is. Eat pillows! I did find it on the first floor because I remember specifically saying, because I was fighting Bullet King, that I was committing regicide using a pillow. I pressed the blank button and it didn't work the first time I pressed it for some reason. So we're not getting a flawless, which is very, very disappointing. Bullet King is very flawlessable. Hey, I knocked it out there. Ugh. Kinda wanna save my pillow ammo now that I don't need to worry about not getting hit. Wait, did I see pistol ammo there? Because I meant save my pillow ammo. Time for you to go, Bullet King. Bye. Right, credit, a little bit of cash, ammo for my pillow gun, classic sniper? Yeah, sniper rifle, scope creep. What does that mean? Don't think I've had just a bog standard sniper. I had a sniper that had, like, it was called Magic Sniper or something like that during the live stream, and it had a chance of turning enemies into a chicken. Low rate of fire, piercing. Now that's impressive, or important. Handcrafted by the rifle gun dead, each sniper rifle performs slightly differently. Though the Gungeon rarely offers many opportunities for distance shooting, this gun still rewards a steady hand. Okay, I'm just debating what to do with the 66 shells we have. I pressed the... There we are. What could I afford? I could afford a half heart and a key, or I could buy the bomber gun. I think I'm going to buy the key, buy a heart, buy another heart, go back to full HP, and consider that reasonable. Look at this arena. Just look at it. So yeah, we'll be using... Well, actually no, I should probably test the sniper's damage first before I decide that it's a boss killer. It's only got 80 rounds though, which is not amazing. Let's see though, as we enter Chamber 2. One day I will get beyond Chamber 4, I swear. Alright, so it pierces, so line up enemies. I already like this gun, although I am, like, a sniper in general. I enjoy using sniper rifles, so I'm predisposed to like any sniper weapon, but yeah, that felt effective. And that's more important than just enjoying firing the gun. Is it a boss killer, though? I think this might fall into the category of both. However, slow firing weapons against certain bosses do not work. You want a perfect example? The beholder, the gun holder. You need a rapid fire weapon to kill him, because otherwise his missiles will hit you. And that's unfortunate, but it's just the way it is. I'm not wasting that on. Alright, we got a free key. I kind of feel bad about buying one now, but we do need two for the floor, so it's not terrible. I'll go down to like half ammo, 40 ammo, then I'll hold on to the rest until I decide what I'm doing with it. No one up here? Being stalked. Two shots on the cube is not terrible, and one shot for standard guys. Plus it pierces. Terrible shot. There we are. Oh, it had to be one of you. I'm curious how many shots you'll take. 3. Pretty damn good. Alright, we found our shop. We don't have a lot of cash, but we'll have a look anyway. Table tech range, the compass, the primer thingy. Oh, gun muncher. I would be willing to trade out the pillow plus something else, but I'm definitely not getting rid of a sniper. Absolutely not. So on the off chance, well, if we find another gun, I will do this. So we'll use the pillow for a little while. Oh, we can't do anything in the shrine room as far as I'm aware. Actually, wait, maybe now that we've saved that king, I can. Who knows? I should check after I unlock things. Oh, okay. So, where's night room likely to be? It could be anywhere we haven't explored yet. Let's try this way. I think the pillow gun also has a chance to stun, if I remember correctly. I love that you fluff it to reload it. Is that it? Quick room. For how big it was. Alright, we found our boss. We're not going to do our boss yet. Although I could use the pillow on the boss and then still potentially trade out. But I'd rather use the pillow to clear the rooms for now. Because it's doing it pretty well. As long as it's not the gun holder, I can use the sniper on the boss. Yeah, it only takes like 4 hits with the pillow to kill one of those cubes. And that could be an item room down here based on the way it's shaped. I'm still not sure if this buffer guy just gives them like a damage or fire rate buff, or if he literally makes them invincible. Because if he does literally make them invincible, then I'd be doing it wrong. No, wait, no, no, he can't do that though. Because I've had situations where he's the last one alive in the room and he runs at you and tries to suicide on you. I mean, how can I not snipe the snipers? It's so satisfying. Ammo. Ammo for the sniper for sure. So that was not where I wanted to be. Let's try up here. And hope that we find our item room. And that we find a gun that's not good enough to hold on to. Because I'm not gun munching my sniper. No way in hell. Is he buffed because there's a buffer somewhere or because he's just like a champion spawn? I jumped towards him to crush the small slime and got hit, which is unfortunate, but he's not a boss, so it doesn't really matter. He was getting buffed by this guy. Now, there's proof that it doesn't make them invincible. What did I tell you about shooting the triangle shape at me? You know that letter in the alphabet, triangle? It's my favourite. I've got 72 pillows left. Yes, we'll just open it. It's the mimic ring. I've still never seen a mimic. But now if I do, they'll be my friends, so that'll... As far as like luck of the draw there, that's not terrible. I need another gun though. And there wasn't one for sale in the shop, so it's not like I can just buy one. Even if I don't like it. Oh, we need to fluff. We do still have one more item room to find, right? Yeah. Worth it for the shells. Oh, there was something special down there, but I missed what that was. Oh, it's the happy man. Okay. I don't know if I've found him since the live stream I did. I don't think I have. Oh wait, it's locked with a key? Oh, you better be worth it. Oh wait, no, it's the Link guy! Am I holding this upside down? Oh, hello there! I seem to have gotten turned around. This map doesn't seem to be accurate, at least not anymore. I'm sure you've noticed, but the walls keep shifting. It's not like the other dungeons I've explored at all. Do you think you could help me map out this place? Sure. Wonderful, you go that way and I'll keep mapping this room. We can meet there. So you want me to map the whole floor? I mean, I'm doing... Oh, can I take your sword? Hey, listen! Stop that! Hey, listen! Alright, you're very clearly a Link parody. Got it. So that just means a general person you can talk to. I thought it specifically meant the round guy that turned out to be the elevator man. Oh, map complete. Nice job. I don't have a key, unfortunately. I've also been forgetting I have an ammo drop because I'm the Marine. But let's see what our reward is for doing this. Hopefully a gun. No, but that door was on the other side last time. Oh, it's you again. How's the mapping coming along? Share completed map. Thank you. You should take this. A strange old man gave it to me. The MAC-10. Alright, the MAC-10 is pretty garbage, so I'll be trading it in the pillow. For something. No. Did you have a key for sale? You did not. Of course you didn't. Well, Mr. Gun Muncher, you may have this. And you may have the pillow. Give me something good. What is this? Have I had this? Colt 1851, you dig? Oh, it's a, what, Dirty Harry's gun? It might be good. Huh, kind of rapid fires. It could be good. It could be. Alright, we'll kill the boss because I might get a key from the boss before I go break open that other chest. We'll start with the sniper and see how it goes. I could also buy armor before doing the fight. Let's risk it. Ugh. And then I immediately get hit! On the plus side, the sniper does indeed do a lot of damage to the Amalconda. Is it doing more damage because I'm piercing multiple sections of it? Is that what's happening here? Is it like Larry Jr. and Isaac? No, I don't think it is. Can't tell if that's doing more or less, really. Doesn't seem to have great range. Well, actually no, it does. It has fine range, it's just it gets very inaccurate. Whereas the sniper, obviously, it can just shoot the length of the room. Thought I had a blank left, I did not. Did I not pick up a third one? I mean, clearly I didn't, but I thought I did. I might be confusing it with last run. Terrible fight, but that's okay. Molotov launcher is good. Had it before. It's a good room opener. It's not a good room closer. We didn't get a key, so I will just be blowing up the chest. And I'm going to buy armor. Or I could buy a half R. Back to full HP. So the chest was... down there. Got rubbish. The reason I pick up the junk, by the way, is I think maybe the more... I have absolutely no proof of this, but this is just the way I hope it works. The more junk you have, the higher of a chance that you won't get junk when you blow up a chest, because the game will take pity on you for being so unlucky. Right, so if I scroll up, I get that gun. If I scroll down, I just get that one. I'm just debating... because I'm going to open up each room with a Molotov. We've had this gun before, it's a perfect synergy gun. Oh, that's a category of gun I never considered. There's room clearers, there's boss clearers, there's guns that kind of do both because they're really good, and then there's synergy weapons like this one, where it's probably not all you want to use, but you start with that because it helps you out a lot. Case in point. Burn! Oh, you're immune to flame, I guess. Oh wait, no you're not. Unfortunately, the ammo for this is going to get burnt through real quick. And then I'm going to have to decide, do I use my ammo drop on this, or wait until my sniper's out of ammo? I guess we'll see. This is a good room clear. Also, I totally forgot to do that first. By all means, walk through the fire. It's on your side, I'm sure. I'm feeling a lot more comfortable now, although, you know, we have no armor and only 3 HP. We just got another blank as well. So this time I do have 3 blanks, try and remember that. Yeah, I'm feeling a lot more comfortable with my weapons now. Certainly in comparison to how I felt on floor 3 last run. Which did not feel comfortable at all. Where's this guy? There he is. Second wave. Nope. shoot out bullets when you die? No. Because you burn to death, I guess. Oh, he is fast because he started immolated since he spawned on my fire. 29 bullets left. Ah! I'm gonna call in an ammo drop for it. I've got plenty of sniper ammo for the boss, assuming the boss is not the beholder. Gun holder, I mean. Enemies? Enemies? I guess not. Oh, one of them down there? No, sniper. Oh, hey, I killed him. Got 54 sniper rounds left. That's not bad. Oh. Sniper rounds? Yeah. Oh. There's someone locked on this floor somewhere. Interesting. Right, I have to live through the floor then. Oh. Oh, this old guy's here. Yeah, sometimes you can find this old guy in a room by himself as well. So he always seems to sell the Elder Blank for 91. Table Tech Blank for 63. I mean, I can't afford anything here, but... it's more options. Hegemonic Carbine, that's... I had that during the live stream I did. It's an effective low-tier early weapon, but it kind of is crappy the deeper in you get. And that's the invincibility thing, right? Yeah. I will hold on to my money for now, see how desperate I get for HP, perhaps. We need to find whoever's locked in this floor and free them. Because then at least I've achieved something if I die, or when I die. I don't think this one's going the distance, but I guess we'll see. As comfortable as I am with my current weapon selection. Also, didn't mean to go to that weapon, but whatever. Good money. Ah, close. Alright, everyone dead? If it needs to be dead. I'll just let Mr. Molotov take care of you. Oh, it's the Squidward thing. Oh, hey, a Fulhar! Wow! Alright, great. If I really, really screw up prior to the boss, there's the boss. I don't like that it appears as a half heart on the map when it is actually a full heart, although I think that might be the first time I've ever seen a full heart drop after a room. Maybe the cell is up here? Still could be. Is there a grenade alive or is it dead? Oh, there it is. It's one of those buckled spurs. I'm actually surprised that they can be burned. Probably not worth using on one guy. Very nearly didn't make that. Sniper died, yes. No win. He did not die. Well, the sniper died, but not him. Something's still alive. And a half heart? Bloody hell. It's not going to matter if the boss really kicks my ass, though. Oh, there's a buffer. Also, really bad position. That's fine, there's a half heart. Or a full heart if I get hit again. Oh, okay, that's just taking the piss now. Give me armor! These do disappear eventually. No keys and there wasn't any in the shop. Could get one for the boss though, so we'll ignore it for now. Still trying to find the cell. That looks kind of rude, standing like that. Just say. Really shouldn't have done that because of what he's about to do, yeah. I asked for that. But again, there's another half heart on the floor, so who cares? Oh, perfect spawn there. Apart from the enemy that, you know, spawned literally on me. There's a room up here, eh? This could be a cell. Walk over the fire, by all means. Yeah, right over here. Good. I hate these immolated things. Another chest. Son of a bitch. Oh, and this big room. Nope. Where is my cell? That special one of them, it's a different color. Ah, fence cell, perfect. Vampire lady? Da da da, you freed me, why? I shot at her, she has some kind of deflection field, and she said yes. Okay. Well, we're not going to get two keys on this floor, but... I need a heart and a half, so I do actually need both drops. Alright, we're going to be as ready for the boss as I can ever be. Who am I hoping for? I don't know. If it's Cannonball Rog, I can't really use the Molotov to great effect, which would be a shame. Got 100, hang on. With 102, I could buy some armor. Not that it's going to stop me getting... or maybe ammo for the Colt. Okay. That may have been impulse buying, but it might also save my life. Oh crap, it's a tank. The tank is suck. That's what the tank is. Too much HP, it sucks when it spawns in help. I would not be surprised if, despite coming into this with 3 full hearts and 1 armor, that he still kills me. He needs to be nerfed massively. Can, to some good effect, just do big circles of the room, but the fact he spawns help is just—it's so annoying. If he didn't spawn help, it'd be manageable. That's all we need to change: just stop him being able to spawn help. I'm trying to predict where he's going now. It's the fact that it's machine gun guys as well. It's not even that it's pistol guys, it's bloody AK-47 guys who are hard. Tried to run me over there. The sniper is actually very good for handling the help he's spawning though. Because it pierces as well, so I could still hit him sometimes. We are going to kill him. Even if he nails me a couple more times, he is going to die. Which will be the first time I've killed the tank, but I had to come in with full bloody HP and really good weapons to be able to do it. That boss is going to get redone, I guarantee it. Alright, 3 hegemonic credits, armor back, stinger again. Alright, we've had this before, it fires bees. Didn't leave any other HP on the floor, did I? No. But we do have two chests to shoot, because we didn't get any keys. Alright, we needed that heart, so I won't complain. God, that's the nearest teleport to the other one. 40 rounds left for the sniper. So, the stinger... I can't remember if the stinger was effective or not. I know it spawns bees on impact, but it's no other bee gun, that's for damn sure. And of course we've got more rubbish, perfect. Alright, we are done on this floor. Got full coat ammo in there now. We're missing up 100, but that's fine. There we go! Feeling okay. I mean, we're practically at full HP, right? So that's not terrible. But we know how bad the bosses are on floor 4, so we need something good to happen. Not got a lot of experience on floor 4. This is the fifth time I've been here. You can kill these, I didn't realise that, but you can. You do also just melt if you kill everything else in the room. Yeah, they're doing damage over time, and there is initial impact damage, so it's not terrible. I would say it's not a boss killer, though. Oh, that was quick fire, bloody hell. Figured there'd be a wave two. Oh, I think I hit him. I did. Those super wizards are hard to manage. It's the fact the bullets move, like they wiggle at you. I think I got him? Yeah, second wave spawns, I must have. That is a really terrible place for that Molotov to land, because now I can't use the cover properly. I've got the cure to your problem. There it is. Alright, we needed that, good. It's getting tense now. Ah! Well, at least it shattered. Oh, the room actually got cleared by that. Okay, we lost our armor, but that's fine. Bees. Maybe my synergy should now be that, followed by bees, followed by coal. Seems to work out fairly well. Ugh. Oh, I was standing on the spikes there and took damage, didn't I? Wasn't focusing on that at all. Enjoy burning. I assume you're burning. Yes, you are. Right, now I need to find a shop because I'm not happy that I'm at half health. Oh, we don't have a goddamn key. No, we can't get out from this way. Key drops are way too rare. Oh, this guy. No. I would rather buy something guaranteed than risk the gamble at this point. Gun Muncher. Well, Stinger isn't so good, so I could get rid of Stinger and... I would have to get rid of the Molotov Launcher, though. Yeah, I'm willing to try for something super amazing. Stinger's not going to help me on this floor, it is not good enough. I do kind of lament getting rid of the Molotov launcher, but I want the sniper and I want the Colt. So let's see what we get. We're throwing it all against the wall now. Is that a bolt gun? Corsair, plot a course. It's going to fire bolts. Circumnavigates the room, then explodes. Many years ago, Gungeon Marines mariners, sorry, used wind to propel their bullets instead of combustion. The trips would take so long to cross a room that the bullets would sometimes mutiny and change course entirely. I've got to charge it. Okay. Does it ever stop? It does. X marks the spot. I get it. This gun seems novel, but also trash. I guess we'll try it, though. So I don't think I got luck of the draw there at all. It's one of those zombie rooms. I hope I can't get hit by my own shots from this gun, because that would be very bad. X is marking the spot all over the place. Yeah, this gun's pretty weak. It's novel that it bounces and it could potentially hit other targets, but no. I got a bad draw there. These low enemies have gotten tougher. They're surviving one shot from this. That was some of the worst aiming I've ever done. Ammo. For the Colt it has to be. Unfortunately, even though the sniper's getting low as well. I can buy some ammo for the sniper, potentially, in the shop. Fine. I wonder if they still die in 2 hits from the sniper. Oh, zombies. Zombie bullets. Ah. Oh. Something's summoning the super zombie. You are. No, wait, no, no, you're not, I think. Maybe you are. Either way, you're dead. Oh, perfect. I'll take that for my sniper if you don't mind, rather. If I find another gun that's also crap, I could... Oh wait, no, gun munchers only work once per floor. I tested that in the live stream. He's doing some kind of buff thing. And now he's dead. Okay. Nope, money. We found our fourth floor boss, but I'm in no way feeling like I'm ready for it. Give me the shop and then maybe. There is a special room connected to this one, because I saw some kind of special symbol on the map. This might be a room where this is viable, because it might hit the buffer wherever he's hiding. The little pussy that he is. I didn't see what hit me there. I didn't see what hit me there either. Oh, I'm getting chased by little sword guys. I didn't see them. Well, we're one hit away from death. We have found our shop, but we can't even get in from this. Oh, I have to use a key to get in. Screw you. That's terrible. I went in my shop. It's my only chance of living. God damn. Just have to hope we get a key real soon. Or we're screwed. Tommy Gun Ghost, get rid of him so he doesn't spawn a ghost. What is that? Oh, that's just a crossbow guy. Kill him at range. Nope, no summoning. Key, please. Nope. It's not even like I want a key for a chest. I just want a key so I can get in my goddamn shop. Oh, no, 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 no. Very close. Another blank, which is nice. There is an enemy, I hear... Oh, God. That hardly seems fair, I can't see what's shooting at me. Right, I think I got rid of the shotgun guy there. Oh, and that's... Ooh, I must have had just enough iframes there. God, that room sucked. We're just going to shoot this. Maybe it'll drop a key. Nope. You know what? We're just going to shoot this as well. Nope. Screw you too, game. Screw you too. Is that all the rooms? No. If we don't get a key in the room that's down here, it's literally impossible for me to enter my shop. Another one of those weird rooms. Alright. Literally can't enter my shop. Just gotta try and do the boss. It's the statue guys again. I'm definitely dead. There goes all my blanks instantly. Although, because this is piercing, this is actually a very effective weapon against this boss, since I'm damaging multiple. There we go. I mean, that was obvious that was going to happen. A pretty good run. Tied for my furthest. How many credits did we get there? Do I have enough to unlock something now? Yeah, 5 could be. Could unlock something at this guy, mind you, but I'm curious if there's more... Ugh, again, I always do this. I expect the shop to be next to the ogre shop, but this is the bloody tutorial. I did that like 5 times when I was streaming. Hot lead costs 5, box costs 8, heart lunchbox costs 5. Anything HP related seems like a good idea to me, so yeah, I'll buy that heart lunchbox. And that is going to do it. I hope you enjoyed, and I shall see you next time. Ta-ta for now.